Hey there, Hypesters. In the last update, we've completely overhauled how to work with game visuals. So let's take a look at how new visual styles and material properties work. Let's start by taking a look at material properties. We can, of course, find these in the color tab of the toolbar. And when we open one of these up, we can see that we no longer have a bunch of different colors to choose from. We have one single color and a few different sliders. This means that now shadows and ambient colors are no longer handled in each individual visual material. As we look at these sliders, roughness is going to decide how much the light diffuses as it comes off of the object. A low number means very sharp light, while a high number means very diffused light. The metallic slider is going to give objects a more metallic look, and for really shiny metal objects, you're going to want to crank that up all the way to 1. If you want an object to look like it's emitting light, you can turn up this emissive slider, and you can see the higher we go, the brighter this white gets until it is blasting white. So take a note that this is an exponential slider. It does go all the way up to 1000, unlike most of the other sliders, which end at 1. And at 1000, obviously here we are blasting light, but we want to turn this down a little bit and just get it to where it looks like there's some light coming off those windows and light fixtures. Finally, we have the rim slider, which can be used to make the edges of objects brighter. Now that we've gone through the material settings, let's take a look at the visual styles. These can be found in the environment menu. To start, we could select from one of the many preset styles that we have here. But since I'm editing a pre-existing scene, I'm going to start from my old settings and we'll hit the little pencil to open up the menu. The visual styles menu has 4 tabs. The first one is sun, which controls the lighting, but also the visual appearance of the sun. The second tab here is all settings related to the background. Third tab is fog. And the fourth new tab is filters. Let's start with the sun. In the sun tab, we can control its color. We can control the intensity of the sun. We can control the height of the sun. And we can control the direction of the sun. These last two were previously controlled with the sunlight controller, which is still available, but it will override the settings in these menus. So you want to use one or the other, not both. Next, we have the sun glow. If our sun is positioned in the sky so that we can see it, this will control kind of how much that sun glows, how big it looks. But this is purely visual. It does not affect the lighting at all. Below that, we have exposure, which controls the overall exposure of the scene. And then we have some settings here for ambient light. We can, of course, control the ambient light itself. What color is it? And that is a gradient. So we have 3 different colors to choose from here. And then we can control that gradient softness as well as the intensity of the ambient light. The next tab we're going to look at is the background. If you're familiar with the old way the background works, this menu is going to be pretty familiar to you. We can still select between the 3 different background styles. Solid is just a solid color. Gradient puts a gradient in the background. And procedural attempts to make a more realistic looking sky. What settings appear below that will depend on which background style you use. If it's solid, you just have a color and your sky brightness. With gradient, you have the gradient colors, which previously were sky, ground, and fog, but now it is all sky colors. You have the top color, the horizon color, and the bottom color. These colors do, though, affect the fog. And from there, we can also control the softness. We can control the position of the horizon. We can control whether or not the horizon moves as the camera moves around with this toggle here. And finally, like the other one, we can control the brightness of the sky. Finally, we have procedural. This one is kind of similar to the gradient. We have 3 gradient colors to choose from, but then we have a bunch of additional settings here that will affect our sky look and a little bit our sun. And then, of course, at the bottom, again, we have sky brightness. I'm going to set this back to gradient where it was. In fact, I'm going to go back here and I'm just going to undo us back to where we were before. So fog also is a very familiar menu for creators. The only difference here is we now have a tint color, so we can tint the fog to a different color. Otherwise, the fog is kind of pulling its color from the background settings. Last but certainly not least, we have filters. In here, we can adjust bloom, which determines kind of how much bright objects glow. So we can adjust the intensity here as well as the threshold. And you can see as I put the threshold up there, even my emissive colors are blooming a lot less. We turn this bloom way down, we turn our threshold way down, and we can find a nice sweet spot in there where things have a nice little glow, but it's not completely overbearing. The tone map will give your scene a little more of a dramatic look. The vignettes and the vignette threshold, of course, puts a little dark glow around your hype, and you can control the color of that as well. We want to have, for some reason, a pink vignette. We can do that. We have a number of settings here related to color, and these might look a little familiar to anybody who's used photo editing apps, video editing apps. We have brightness, we have contrast, we have saturation. Ooh, nice low saturation. We can bump up the highlight colors, we can bump down the highlights, we can do the same with shadows. And then finally, we have a filter. Right now, there's only one option for a filter in here, but keep an eye out for more in the future. And then we can do a tint color and, of course, a tint strength. There are also nodes that can control the environment, sun, and sky settings. You can find them here in the visual category of the node library. In the future, we'll also be adding a node that will allow you to change the visual styles during your game. I hope you found this video helpful, and let us know in the comments below what you think of these new rendering features. I, for one, cannot wait to see what you guys do with them. I highly recommend you take a little bit of time, play around with them, see what they can do. And if you've been on HypeHype for a while, you've already got some games, some things that you've made on your profile, I recommend going back and checking them out, making sure they look good with these new render settings, and maybe making them look a little bit better. Thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you in HypeHype. Peace out, hypesters. In the last update, we've completely overhauled how to work. Sorry, I need to wake up. Objects of objects. That was bad. Stop improvising. Oh God, I'm losing my mind. Thanks for watching. Until next time, I'll see you in HypeHype. Peace out, hypes. Don't hit the microphone. That was okay, I think, actually.